Well, it's a good thing I built this record rack for the show today so that we can go through all these albums and figure out what one's going to be the hit tonight for the party. Peter, Paul, and Mary? Absolutely. This is the one. Do the Hustle, which is what we're going to do because we're going to come right back and build this rack.
Welcome back to Matt's Basement Workshop. Sponsored by patrons of Matt's Basement Workshop. Audience-funded support through Patreon.com. Sign up today at patreon.com/Matt's Basement Workshop.
Hey everybody, welcome back to Matt's Basement Workshop. So we've been doing a lot of small projects lately, and I think we have one here that kind of straddles the small project, but at the same time, you gotta put a little effort into it, and it takes a little bit more than scraps, but essentially that's kind of what we're working with here, some of the bigger scraps. So let me go ahead and take the massive Vanderlist vinyl collection out of the way and show you what we have here. Now, just to let you know, I happen to see this project, or a project very similar to it, on Pinterest, and I said, oh man, I really need to get down and build something like this, because I have some friends that do have rather large vinyl collections, and they occasionally like to take some out and put them right on display so people could see them. And I thought, you know, the really neat thing about it is this is totally a breakdown project. I mean, it's only, in this situation, these four pieces. They're pretty sturdy. It can be set away in case you're not going to use it, or maybe you want to ship it cross-state, cross-country, wherever it is. This is a really neat way to be able to do it, and again, it doesn't take a lot of materials. In fact, what we're using here is just some cherry and some beautiful tiger maple. In fact, once we do the finishing process on this, and we haven't done that quite yet, it's gonna look absolutely amazing. I'm thinking maybe an oil or something to really bring out that chatoyance. It's absolutely gorgeous. But anyways, let's go ahead and get started on building this because it is super simple. So the first thing I need to do is to mill the materials, and I'm going to do that, of course, over at the jointer, and it was a matter of just getting the edges for these panels nice and flush with each other so that we're going to get a really nice tight glue line. So I did the maple first. Then I came back in, did the cherry. Now with the edges freshly jointed, we're going to head over to the table saw where we can rip the stock to width, and we'll just start with the cherry, then move on to the maple. Once we have that done, because of the fact that really this is the most complicated joinery we have in here, okay, we actually have something else, but because it's the most time-consuming joinery, we want to go ahead and do that glue-up. And while it's gluing, it gives us an opportunity to start working on the base. So the first thing, of course, we're going to do is take these pieces over, match them up, and you'll notice that what I'm doing is rather than cutting the cherry piece down into several different pieces, I'm just going to kind of glue this all up together. Now, I didn't glue up the butt ends of the maple, but I just kind of butted them up one another, and I just did one large glue-up. Set that aside, and it was time then to come in and work here on the base. So the first thing to do is to cut the two base components to length. Now this is one piece of cherry that will easily yield both of the components. The base, it can be any length you want. In fact, you could make this much more extended so that you could fit even more albums in there. And the only thing we really need to do, at least what I did for this one, is I had it already ripped to the width that I want, which is somewhere around about 2 inches, something like that, 2-3 inches. And I just need to come in and do these angled cuts. As you can see on the sacrificial fence here, I have got a cut that's coming in. This is about 15 degrees. And what I want to do is be able to transfer those cuts to the base pieces. So what I did, you notice I have two pencil lines here. This first one is actually going to reference this outside edge. And the second one is going to reference this inside. So what I then did was I kind of drew in where the angles are for these. And I said, all right, so I just kind of repeated that. I made matching pieces here, so I got the right thickness. And then I will just match up that first edge here, which will make sure that I get the angle within that line. Shift it to the side, and then now I should get the angle exactly within this little area. And I did it for both ends, so I can just simply flip it over and repeat it on both sides. You notice I've got the pieces taped together here so that I can make the pieces, the cuts simultaneously. And I made sure to wrap the tape equal the number of times so that it stays nice and level. And here's the result. We have the angles going out the way you want them. And you can kind of see in there that as we nibbled it away, obviously it's not a very flat bottom, but that's no big deal because we'll just come in with a chisel and pare that out. Once we're done doing the angle for both pieces on the base, it's time to set those aside and start working on the panels, because at this point we've had plenty of time for the glue to dry. It's all set up and we're going to take it out of the clamps, and now we're going to head over to the thickness planer and we're going to bring it down to the same size, because the maple was much thicker, not really much, it was just thick enough that it was different than the cherry. So we're going to run it through the thickness planer, bring it down so it's all the same thickness, and we're going to do that in just a couple of passes. Now one thing I did do was I had to keep coming back in and checking to make sure that the thickness of the board was going to fit in here nice. I want to make sure these panels fit snug, but not too snug, so I definitely was checking them out. And one thing I noticed was, and we can kind of see it here and get a close-up in this little snippet, if I left that bottom edge at a 90 degree angle, well, you can see there's a little bit of a gap. It's not really that big of a deal when it comes down to it, but I thought it would just look much nicer if we went ahead and matched that angle on the top and bottom of the panel. So that's exactly what we did. When we cross-cut the panels, because we already had the blade all set up at the 15 degrees, we hadn't touched it between when we finished up the base, we made our first pass, and then we went ahead and just simply marked where the length that we wanted, flipped it over, cut the other one, and now we have matching angles at both ends. And what that really does is it gives us a really nice clean look. Now this one has a little bit of this kind of like gum kind of a look in here. I think that's a really neat look with the cherry itself. But essentially, here you go. The nice thing about that is with having this angle up here, it just makes everything look parallel. It looks nice. You don't have to do it. In fact, I'm almost thinking like maybe if we rounded over these panels, that would be really neat. You could definitely do something with it just to kind of spruce it up, use different species, all that good stuff. This one still has a little bit of touch-up work I have to do, just kind of some sanding, some scraping, and of course coming up with that finish that we want to use on it. But more or less, it is all done, and our massive vinyl collection in the Vanderlist household has a really great place to go. So now I know where that Peter, Paul, and Mary album is the next time I want to listen. Anyways, if you have comments, questions, suggestions, I would love to hear from all of you. You can email me at mattsbasementworkshop@gmail.com. Of course, you can leave a comment in the show notes over at the website for today's episode. You can find that at mattsbasementworkshop.com. You can leave a comment over at YouTube. I love hearing from all of you. So until the next time, I will be talking to you later. Who knows, maybe we'll come up with something for my massive tape collection that I had. I had the best Chevette with the most awesome stereo system ever when I was in high school. But anyways, we'll figure out what's going to come up on the next episode before then. So until then, straight grains and sharp blades. Take care, everybody.
Thanks for watching. For more information on topics discussed in this episode, visit mattsbasementworkshop.com. Also, please consider becoming a patron of Matt's Basement Workshop. Get early access to new shows, bonus content from each episode, and so much more. Visit patreon.com/Matt's Basement Workshop to sign up and start receiving your benefits today.